Rain and a bit of snow is once again on its way to San Diego County. National Weather Service meteorologist Alex Tardy says it should roll into the county around 10 tonight.
It'll first come into North County and then pretty quickly fill into downtown San Diego. So I would say most of the rain is going to be when everyone's asleep.
Tardy says tomorrow morning's commute will be difficult, so remember to keep more space than usual between you and other vehicles. The Farmers Insurance Open Golf Tournament began today at Torrey Pines. There are no spectators this year thanks to COVID, and there likely won't be any players on the course Friday. Tournaments can play in rain, but PGA rules say play stops if water starts to puddle on the course, and it looks like we'll have enough rain for that to happen.
Most people will see an inch and a half of rain. So an inch and a half of rain is more rain than what we've even seen in most places this entire winter.
Another concern, areas that were hit by fire in the past year or so. Too much rain means potentially dangerous mudslides.
There will be some mud that moves around over in the valley, fire scar in East County, east of Alpine. I don't think it'll be life-threatening or necessarily damaging type.
We're halfway through our rainy season, and Tardy says we've only gotten about 30% of average precipitation. This storm and another smaller one that should arrive the middle of next week will help.
After this storm, it should put a big dent into it, but it won't get us back to normal or average. It won't be enough.
Long range, Tardy says we're looking to stay fairly dry.
It continues to look like a winter where we have one or two storms in a week, and then we go 3 weeks with very little. Usually when you're in those type of winters, you fall short.
Fortunately, this story can end on a positive note because of what's happening to our north. Tardy says the coming storms will take the snowpack from Mammoth up to Tahoe from about 25% of average to 75%. Of course, when that snow melts, a lot of that water is delivered to Southern California. John Carroll, KPBS News.